Hey there, I'm Desi Sanchez, and this is VEVO's Sound and City. We're going on the road to America's most legendary music cities to show you where bands hang out when they come to town. It's a backstage pass to the hottest venues, tastiest restaurants, and coolest bars and clubs. And what tour would be complete without a stop here? America's music city, the country music capital of the world, Nashville, Tennessee. Nashville has country music in its blood. Every street, shop, honky-tonk, and alleyway is packed with music history. Just behind me at the historic Grimey Auditorium, the Grand Ole Opry gave starts to country titans like Hank Williams, Johnny Cash, Patsy Cline, and Loretta Lynn, just to name a few. But Nashville's finest days are not in the past. Today, there's a new school of country music stars that are keeping Music City shining. And I caught up with one of the brightest, Josh Turner, to tell us what's keeping Nashville alive and kicking.
My dream was to write and to perform, and I knew that to take it to that next level, I was going to have to come to Nashville. I'm around the music on a daily basis. I can get things from Nashville that I can't get in rural South Carolina. And, you know, when I get away from that for a certain period of time, I start craving it.
From the man in black to the backwoods Barbie, country stars know it's look good or go home. And if you just got in town for a gig and realized you left your chaps back in Boise, then stop in here to the legendary Katy K's. And Katy herself will get you saddled up.
Music is everything in Nashville, and people that are in music have to be dressed up.
Have you dressed any notable musicians?
We've had Annie Lennox. We have had Porter Wagoner, Emmylou Harris, Elvis Costello, and Jack White. Okay, this is super 70s, but it belonged to Conway Twitty's drummer.
Check that out. Check out the boots. For other much-needed stage attire, check out Goodbye Girls, High Class Hillbillies, and Old Made Good for great vintage picks. And for the perfect pair of jeans, stop by Imogene and Willie's. This is Prince's Hot Chicken Shack, where for over 60 years, musicians and fans have come to Andre Prince Jeffrey's kitchen to try the hottest thing this side of Dixie. Now, what makes this the spot for touring musicians to come and fill their bellies?
We used to be, I think, about the only late night place open back then. So after they were recording down there at the Grand Ole Opry, they would come by my uncle's place.
But there's a lot of musicians come in here. I guess it kind of wakes them up.
Also try Arnold's Country Kitchen for fried chicken livers, Nashville's Biscuit House for, well, biscuits, Brown's Diner for burgers, and James Beard nominee Tandy Wilson's City House. If you're looking to discover the next big thing, then you've got to find your way to this backdoor entrance, aptly named The Basement. The Basement may be tiny, but this intimate club's been breaking bands since it opened beneath Grimey's new and pre-loved music 7 years ago. And that's no small credit to owner and local music guru Mike Grimes. We caught up with Grimes to get the inside scoop on The Basement's success and what's going on in Nashville today.
We're the premier independent music store in Nashville, located above The Basement, a live music venue. Both were created and exist as an outlet to bring the local independent music community together. The Basement sets itself apart in that I'm kind of a fan of anything and everything that sounds like it's passionate, you know. We've had everybody from Metallica to Mumford & Sons to the most outsider or acts like Jandek. The local scene has been just building and building and building over the last 10 years. We really have an amazing time right now.
To hear other cool new country acts, check out Dino's, The Mercy Lounge, Roberts, and the Belcourt Theater. Spend a night here in Nashville and you'll have music in your blood too. So while you could hit the bars, don't be surprised if, like me, you start itching to get on stage yourself. And that's why we're here at the one and only Santa's Pub. Owned and operated by Santa himself, this converted trailer is home to Friday night's merriest karaoke stage. Let's go chat with Santa.
The Mars Minter since 1962, and then April last year I bought it. I was a customer about 8 years. So I always liked the bar, and then when it closed down, I bought it over there. I painted the sound on the outside, built the deck, fixed it up, and it just happened from there. They started just coming in.
If you're looking for other stages, stop by Lonnie's Western Room, Purple Haze, or the Five Spot. But remember, here in Nashville, make sure you bring your good stuff, because in this city, everybody's got the goods. Thanks for tagging along, and we'll see you at our next stop on tour, only on VEVO's Sound and City. Bye.